Nano is the default terminal-based text editor in Ubuntu and many other Linux distributions. It is an open-source software licensed under GPL and it comes under the umbrella of GNU software. Hence, you will often find it referred as GNU Nano. Nano can be used to edit text files, script files, program files, etc. Please keep in mind that it is not a word processor, so it cannot be used to edit doc files or PDF files. For simple text editing of configuration files, script files, or text files, Nano is a great choice. The learning curve for Nano is much easier than other popular terminal text editors like Vim or Emacs. Just because it is less complicated to use than the likes of Vim and Emacs, it does not mean that Nano cannot be overwhelming to use. And this is why this course will teach you all the basics you need to know to edit files with Nano Editor in Linux Terminal. Nano comes pre-installed on many Linux distributions. It is highly likely that it is already installed on your system. How to know that? It's simple. Open a terminal and use the following command. Nano --version. If it outputs some details about Nano version, this is an indication that Nano is already installed on your system. You may see something like this, and the version could be different depending upon your distribution and system. If you see an output like Nano command not found, you need to install it. And installation is really easy. Just use your distribution's package manager. For example, in Debian and Ubuntu, you can use sudo apt install nano and nano will be installed. Using nano is a lot simpler than Vim or Emacs. You can start writing or editing text straight away. Open nano editor with the following command, nano. You'll notice a new interface in your terminal that reads like GNU nano and displays new buffer. This new buffer means Nano is working on a new file. This is equivalent to opening a new unsaved file in a text editor. Nano editor shows all the important keyboard shortcuts you need to use for editing at the bottom of the editor. This way, you won't get stuck while using Nano. This caret symbol means control key and this M means alt key. So when it says MU, it means you have to use LTU, and when it says caret G, it means you have to use control G. Another thing is, the wider your terminal window is, the more shortcuts it shows. And the shortcuts are usually related to what you are doing in your editor. You will see more about it later when you explore it. There's a detailed help available and you can just press control G. And you can see all the keyboard shortcuts, everything in detail in the help text. Now that you are a bit familiar with the interface, exit the Nano editor with Control X keys. Since you have not made any changes to the opened unsaved file, you won't be asked to save it. Awesome! Now that you have some ideas about the editor, in the next module, you will learn to create and edit files with Nano. You can open a file for editing in Nano like this, nano file name. If the file does not exist, it will still open the editor and when you exit, you will have the option to save the file. You can also open a new file without any name at all. Try it in a terminal, just write nano and enter. You will see a new buffer. Since you did not give the file any name, it indicates that it is a new unsaved file in the memory buffer. You can start writing or modifying the text straight away in Nano. There are no special insert mode or anything of that sort. It is almost like using a regular text editor, at least for writing and editing part. If you make any changes to the file, new or existing, you will notice that an asterisk appears beside the file name or new buffer. This means the file has been modified and the changes have not been saved yet. How to save the file and exit it, that you will see in the next chapter. So you have learned to open and create files with Nano. Do you still have the file open from the previous chapter? If not, open a brand new file. You know how to do it, so I'm not going to show it to you again. So let's save the changes and close the file. Nothing is saved immediately to the file automatically unless you explicitly tell Nano to do so. And how do you do that? When you exit the editor using Ctrl X keyboard shortcut, you will be asked whether you want to save the file. You can press Y to save the file and exit the editor, N to discard the changes, and C to cancel the saving but continue the editing of the file. If you choose to save the file by pressing the Y key, you will be asked to give the file a name. Name it myfile.txt. The txt extension is not necessary because the file is already a text file, even if you do not use the extension. However, it is a good practice to keep the file extension for comprehension. Enter the name and press the Enter key. Your file will be saved and you will be out of the Nano editor interface. You will see the text file has been created in your current directory. Let's open a file again and put a random text into it. And this time, I'll try to exit it again. And while exiting it, instead of saving it, you can press C to cancel the exiting and continue the editing, or press Ctrl X again and put N to discard the changes. You see, the file has not been saved. In gedit or notepad, you get the save as option to save the changes made to an existing file as a new file. This way the original file remains unchanged and you create a new file with the modified text. You can do it in Nano editor as well. And the good thing is that you don't need to remember another shortcut for this. You can use the same Ctrl X keys that you used for saving and exiting. Let's see it in action. Open the sample file you had downloaded earlier. If you don't make any changes, Ctrl X will simply close the editor. You don't want to do that, do you? So just press Enter and then Backspace key. This will insert a new line and delete it. This way, nothing in the text file is changed, and yet Nano will see it as a modified file. If you press Ctrl X and press Y to confirm the saving of the file, you will come to the screen where it shows the file name. What you can do here is to change the file name here by pressing the Backspace key and typing a new name. It will ask to confirm saving it under a different name. Press Y to confirm this decision. I named it agathacomplete.back as an indication that it is a backup of a file of the same name. It's just for convenience. There's no real significance behind the back extension. So you have learned to save files with Nano in this lesson. And in the next one, you will learn to move around a text file in Nano Editor. Open the agatha_complete.txt file with Nano. You know how to open files with Nano Editor now, right? So now you have a text file with several lines. How do you switch to other lines or to the next page or to the end of the line? Mouse clicks don't work here. Use the arrow keys to move up and down and left and right. You can use the home key or Ctrl A to move to the beginning of a line, or end key or Ctrl E to move to the end of the line. Ctrl Y or page up and Ctrl V or page down keys can be used to scroll by pages. If you are in doubt, you can always press the Ctrl G to get the detailed help page. You have not made any changes to the file, so just exit it. And now open the same file again, but using this command, add the minus L here. Did you notice something different? The minus L option displays the line number in the left hand side. Why did I show that to you? because I want you to learn to go to a specific line now. To do that, use Control and underscore key combination. You will notice that the help option has changed at the bottom. That's the beauty of Nano. If you choose a special keyboard shortcut, it starts showing the option that can be used with the key combination. So here you can enter a line or column number and you can just move and the cursor will jump to the said line. At the same time, it shows that you can enter Ctrl plus Y to go to the first line of the file. It is different from the regular Ctrl plus Y for moving one page up. Similarly, using Ctrl T at the same screen, when you are going for line number, if you press Ctrl T, this will take you to a certain text. That's almost like searching for a specific text. And that brings us to the topic of the next lesson, which is search and replace. You still have the sample text file open, right? If not, open it again. Let's see how to search for a text and replace it with something else. Let's start with the search first. If you want to search for a certain text, use Ctrl W and then enter the term you want to search and then press Enter. The cursor will move to the first match. To go to the next match, use Alt plus W. By default, the search is case insensitive. You can perform a case sensitive search by pressing Alt plus C when you are about to perform a search. You can see that it says case sensitive now. And also, you will see that it displays the previous search term inside brackets. Some new options can be seen at the bottom, of course. For example, you can use Alt plus R to do a regular expression search. While typing for a search, if you want to come out of it, use Ctrl C. That was about searching for a term. How about search and replace? If you want to replace the search term, use Ctrl plus backslash keys and then enter the search term and press Enter key, of course. Next, it will ask the term you want to replace the searched item with. So here I'll replace murder with maris because some people think it's the same thing. The cursor will move to the first match and Nano will ask you for your confirmation for replacing the match text. Use Y to confirm and N to deny it. Using either of Y or N will move to the next match. You may also use A to replace all matches. So in this text, I have replaced all the occurrences of murder with maris. You have made some changes to the text file in this lesson, but there's no need to save those changes. You know how to discard the changes and exit Nano Editor, right? Press Ctrl X and when asked for save, just don't save it and just exit the editor. In the next lesson, you will learn about cut, copy, and paste. Let's open the same sample text file first. If you don't want to spend too much time remembering the shortcuts, use mouse. Select the text with mouse and then use the right-click menu to copy the text. You can also use terminal-specific shortcuts for copying and pasting. That is, Ctrl plus Shift plus C to copy and Ctrl plus Shift plus V to paste. That's up to you. You can copy-paste between Nano Editor and outside your terminal like a regular editor like gedit or a browser. This makes your job a lot easier for copying pasting command in the terminal or something in the file from the external sources. Nano also provides its own shortcuts for cutting and pasting text, but that could become confusing for beginners. Nonetheless, I'm going to show that to you. Move your cursor to the beginning of the text you want to copy. Press Alt plus A to set a marker. Now use the arrow keys to highlight the selection. Once you have selected the desired text, you can use Alt plus 6 key to copy the selected text. Once you have copied the selected text, you can use Ctrl plus U to paste it. You can see the hint at the bottom of the editor. Similarly, you can set the mark again with Alt plus A. But if you don't want to continue like this, you can use Ctrl plus 6 to cancel the marker. If you want to cut paste something, cut a part of the file, just do the same stuff again. That is, set a marker and then move the arrow for the selection. And then use Ctrl K to cut the selected text. Now you go to the desired location in the file and then use Ctrl U to paste the selected text. You have made a lot of changes to this file, but you're not going to save anything to this. So what you need to do is discard the changes and exit the editor. How do you do that? Ctrl X and then press N. Alright, so now that you know about copy pasting, the next lesson will teach you a thing or two about deleting text and lines in Nano. There is no dedicated option for deletion in Nano. You may use the backspace or delete key to delete one character at a time. Press them repeatedly or hold them to delete multiple characters, just like in any regular text editor. You can also use the control keys that cuts the entire line. If you don't paste it anywhere, it's as good as deleting a line. You can of course use it to paste the line, but that's entirely up to you. If you want to delete multiple lines, you may use Ctrl plus K keys on multiple lines one by one. Like just Ctrl K, Ctrl K, Ctrl K, and it will start deleting the lines one by one. Another option is to use the marker, which you saw in the previous chapter. How do you set a marker? Use Ctrl A. You set the marker and then move the arrow to select a portion of text and then use Ctrl K to cut the text. No need to paste it and the selected text will be deleted in a way. Cut the wrong line, pasted the wrong text selection. It's easy to make such silly mistakes, and it's easy to correct those silly mistakes in Nano. You can use undo and redo on your last actions using the Alt plus U for undo and Alt plus E for redo. You can repeat these key combination to undo or redo multiple times. You can just start playing with it. Make some random changes to your file and then undo those changes and redo it again just to experience the undo and redo actions. Remember, the help is always displayed at the bottom along with information on the last action you performed. That's it. That brings us to the end of this micro course on Nano. I know by now you have a good working knowledge of this awesome Nano editor. Please share your feedback on this course, and if you have any suggestion to improve this course, please let me know. And if you like this course and if it was helpful, you can always donate to us so that we can create more courses which will be helpful not only for you, for all other people in the entire world who want to learn Linux. Bye bye.